Okay, so let's dive right into this. Why is circumcision such an important topic to bring awareness to here in America?
I mean, if I told you there was another issue that affected every man in America, every partner of a man, every child, parent, and family, and that it wasn't something we'd ever had a national conversation about, even though it affected people on the most personal level possible, you'd say, we need to talk about that. That sounds important, right? But we haven't had that around circumcision because it intersects with every taboo that we have around sexuality and religion and people's bodies and all of those things. And so part of the goal of the film is to start that conversation and to get people talking about something that we're all somewhat familiar with but have never thought about on a deeper level.
Right.
And then that affects everyone on a really personal level.
That's true. And so this is America's most controversial but also most common surgery, which is kind of startling when you kind of think of it that way with the juxtaposition of that.
Right. And it's not something that the rest of the world does. I think most Americans assume that this is something that's done everywhere, when in reality it's only done in America and in religious and tribal contexts around the world. Mm-hmm. Europe does not practice circumcision. Asia, most of Asia doesn't. It's seen over there at the same way that we look at female genital cutting. Yet, you know, in our culture, we say try to say, oh, those two are very different. When in reality, you know, when you interview women who've experienced that, they say there's actually a lot of similarities.
So let's talk more about the doc. What's the format? Are you interviewing experts here, people from other countries for their opinions?
So we interview top experts on both sides. We interview members of the American Academy of Pediatrics. We interview people who've done studies overseas and things like that. And we also interview a lot of activists and experts from what's known as the Intactivist movement, which is a movement that believes that all human beings should have the right to their own bodies and the right to make their own choices about their bodies, and cutting off a part of someone's body without their consent is a violation of human rights.
And if you were just gonna, you know, kind of consolidate it for us, what are both sides of the debate? What are the risks versus the rewards?
So the framing of the American Academy of Pediatrics is that this is a parental choice, that parents make all sorts of kinds of decisions for their children, and we should just be allowed to do that for those reasons. The framing of the Intactivists is that human beings have the right to make their own choices about their bodies. You wouldn't evaluate any other body part of your child this way as, oh, what are the risks and benefits of cutting off an earlobe or another? You know, it's sort of absurd to even think about. Yet we do that with the most sensitive part of their body. Mm-hmm. So their position is that this is an important human rights issue and that people should have the right to make their own choices.
Right, and it's kind of at the intersection, as you mentioned in the beginning, sex, politics, religion, but as you're right, it really is basic human rights. Do you think this is something, obviously you're kind of starting this conversation, but do you think this is something we're going to see more and more in the light of, where people maybe are doing it less?
Absolutely. I mean, the rate has already gone down. It used to be as high as 90% in the country. Now it's as low as 50%.
Okay.
And I think a lot of that is due to greater access to information. So it used to be the only information you got was from your doctor or your peer group. And now you can go online and search anything you'd ever want to know about anything.
Mm-hmm.
So there's that aspect too. And overseas, there's a movement against it as well. Iceland is actually considering banning circumcision right now. They've talked about that. They say we have a law against female genital cutting, we should have a law against male genital cutting.
Right.
And it's, you know, Denmark may
be
moving in the same direction.
Makes sense
when
you put it like that.
Yeah.
So how long did it take for you to film this documentary?
6 years.
6 years?
It took a little while, yeah.
Oh my God. So how, I mean, you must have compiled a lot of footage to put together.
There's a lot. This is the most comprehensive documentary ever done on the subject.
Mm.
And it's not something that's really been explored on film before.
Right.
So.
Wow.
Yeah.
So what's the response been? It's already been screening for a few weeks now. Is the response kind of happening to where you wanted it to go? Are people talking about this? Are people, you know, having opinions?
Yeah, it draws a really strong emotional response. I think that people are used to having this issue framed in a medical way, and they haven't had it framed in a human way. And the film covers a lot of people's stories. One of the things I found working on the issue is that when I'd talk to people, they would say, you know, I've never told anyone this, but, or like, you probably haven't heard a story like this, but, and they'd start telling me things, and they didn't realize that there were a lot of people who had the same story.
Mm-hmm.
And so it brings up all of those emotions that people have about, you know, the most personal parts of their life. So, I mean, I would say that we've had more audience members who've been brought to tears than not by the film, because it has that big an emotional reaction in people.
So tell Tell me basically where people can watch currently and maybe where it will be widely released in the future.
So we're doing theatrical screenings now, mm-hmm. and you can find those on our website, circumcisionmovie.com. Mm-hmm. And on Halloween, we're going to be on VOD, so Amazon, iTunes, all of those places. And again, we'll have links to that on the site.
Very exciting. Well, Brendan, thank you so much for sitting down and telling me about this new documentary. It sounds like a really great, great project.
Thank you. I appreciate it.